Kabir.
Hey, Isha. Wow, Dhruv. K.I.D. in the house.
K.I.D. 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 company. K.I.D. 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 company. Look at Kabir boy, he's in the groove. Is that glitter or superstar Dhruv?
And welcome to KID Company. It is a new day. How are you today? What is your plan for the day? Is it Monday, Tuesday, or Sunday? A day, a day, a day, a day. So let us talk about the day today. What is a day? And what is a night? What is the sun which shines so bright? Today we are going to learn what is a day and night, sun, a star, Moon and its phases, artificial and natural satellites, and planets. So come, let us find all about it by joining Kabir, Isha, and Dhruv on a journey to the skies. Let us learn about the universe and the solar system. But before that, let us say good morning to someone who is still sleeping.
Kabir, Kabir, good morning, Kabir. It's time to wake up.
Oh, is it morning already?
It's morning, Kabir. It's a bright sunny day.
Morning again. I wonder why we have day and night at all.
Well, would you want to know why? Kabir, switch on the torch. What can you see?
Yes. I can see a globe. I know, a globe is a miniature of the Earth.
Yes, now let me slowly turn around a bit. What do you see now?
I see the globe, but only half of it.
Okay, let me turn a little more. Maybe that will help you, Kabir.
Oh, yes. Now I can see the other side. But I can't see the remaining half of the globe.
That's right. Your torch is like the sun and the globe is like the Earth. When the Earth rotates from the west to the east, only half of the Earth faces the sun. Sunlight falls on the side of the Earth facing the sun, causing day in those regions. Now, the other side of the Earth, which does not face the sun, experiences night, as no sunlight falls on it. When the Earth rotates, day changes to night and night changes to day. It takes 24 hours for the Earth to make one complete rotation.
Oh, which means if it is day on one part of the Earth, then it will be night on the other part.
That's right. Now you know why we have day and night.
Yes, now it is absolutely clear to me.
Since now we have learned about day and night and how they are formed by the Earth's rotation, what is Kabir and Dhruv doing in the park? I think Kabir is learning something new. Let's join them.
In the morning, the sun rises in the east.
Yes, I have seen that every day.
Do you know, Kabir? As time passes, the sun too appears to move from east to west. And do you know why?
Come on, because the sun moves.
No, the sun does not move. It's actually the Earth's rotation. In other words, the Earth rotates from the west to the east.
And that is why the sun appears to move from east to west?
Correct. You know, Kabir, the sun gives us heat, light, and keeps us alive. And you must know that the sun is a star.
A superstar like Shah Rukh Khan, Salman Khan?
No, a star. Like the tiny shiny dots you see in the sky at night? Those are stars. Look, the sun has set and the stars have appeared.
But you said the sun is a star.
Yes, the sun is a star. But these other stars are very, very far away. So they appear like small tiny dots. The sun is closer to the earth and so it looks big and bright. Objects which are near look big while those that are far away appear small.
But where do the stars go during the day? Do they disappear?
They don't disappear. They are always there. During the day, bright sunlight hides them. And when it's night, the sun is facing the other side of the earth. The stars become visible. Got it?
I got it. Hey, what is that? Big bright ball in the sky?
Oh, that's the moon. Why don't we travel over to it?
Really? But how?
With magic.
Wow!
Let's go!
Hey, me too!
Sure, why not? Jump in!
Wow, beautiful!
Don't fiddle with the controls. Stop it, Isha.
So beautiful.
Isha!
Isha, my sister Isha.
Don't cry, Kabir. I think she has fallen on the moon. Let's go get her.
My sister, my Isha is lost. I'm worried because there are so many moons, you know. There is a half moon, a full moon, and sometimes there's also a less than half moon. God knows where's Isha. Why are you laughing?
There's only one moon, Kabir. The moon is a satellite of the Earth. A satellite is an object which revolves around a planet. The Earth is a planet and the moon is its satellite. It takes the moon 28 days to go once around the Earth. The moon does not have its own light. Just like the Earth, the moon shines because of the sun's rays falling on it. When the moon is in between the sun and the Earth, the side of the moon facing the Earth receives no light. And we call this a new moon. When the Earth is between the sun and the moon, the side of the moon facing the Earth reflects the sun's light and we see a full moon. So we see different shapes of moon as it travels around the Earth, reflecting the light of the sun. These are called the phases of the moon. I think Isha is somewhere in the solar system.
Solar system? What is that?
Our planet Earth is a part of the solar system. A solar system has a star at the center and planets revolving around it. Our solar system has the sun at its center and 8 planets going around it.
Okay, so Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Mercury, Venus, Earth, Uranus and Neptune are all planets of the solar system. And they go around. In other words, revolve around the sun.
Yes.
But where is Isha? Maybe we should check the solar system again from the beginning. Mars, Jupiter, Saturn.
No, that's the wrong order. There's an easy way to remember this. My very efficient mother just served us noodles. The first letter of each word represents the name of each planet. M for Mercury, V for Venus, E for Earth, M for Mars, J for Jupiter, S for Saturn, U for Uranus, and N for Neptune.
Maybe we should check the solar system again.
Mercury, Venus, Earth,
Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and here comes Neptune. Don't cry, Isha. You are safe now. Hey, that's our Earth and the Moon. But what are those?
Satellites. We see a couple of communication satellites.
But you said the Moon is Earth's satellite.
Yes, the Moon is the Earth's natural satellite. These are man-made satellites, made by man. Our television, our mobiles, and the internet works because of these man-made satellites, like the Moon. They also go around the Earth.
My very efficient mother just served us noodles.
What's that?
You are right, Kabir.
Oh, wow. What a journey it was through the space. Thanks to the magical Dhruv for the space journey. Thank God Isha is back and safe. Too much adventure for a day. Too much learning for a day. The sun has set and the day has ended. And so have the learnings. So you go relax a little and meet me, Kabir, Isha and the magical Dhruv in the next episode from the KID company. And to keep learning more, log on to www.topolearning.com. See you. Bye-bye.